This painting is from the central square of Bagno Vignoni, which is an ancient village located in the heart of Tuscany in the Val d'Orcia Park. It's very close to Pienza, Montalcino, Montepulciano, very close, being like 20-minute drives from either of those places. And it's about an hour and a half, 2 hours from Florence. Now, this particular village is probably the only town in the entire country of Italy whose main square is a giant pool. The square is called Piazza della Sorgente, and the pool is known as the Baths of St. Catherine, because from Roman times, this place has been visited by many Italians of note. It was included Pope Pius II, St. Catherine of Siena, who the baths are named from, Lorenzo the Magnificent, many artists who selected this as a holiday resort. But the main reason, the thermal waters in this pool have been used since Roman times. And it contains, this particular pool supposedly contains the original source of water that came from the subterranean aquifer of the volcanic origins. And this goes back to the Etruscans and the Romans. But it is quite a beautiful and peaceful spot. I'd like to talk a little bit about this painting. But first, a little background. Susan and I decided to visit Bagno Vignoni and stay there for a couple of days because it sounded like a very interesting and relaxing spot. I didn't bring a lot of canvases. I did happen to bring a sketchbook and essentially one canvas and also a camera. But the main reason we were there was just to sort of relax and enjoy these spa. However, it's quite an unusual spot, and this being one of the main houses in the square, it was one of the first paintings that I did. I actually started this with the one canvas that I had, and I didn't have an easel, but I was actually, this view is from the opposite wall, and I actually set up on the wall and did some quick sketches. And what I wanted to achieve in this was the reflections, as well as the architectural design of the buildings itself and the wall, which again, it goes back to Etruscan times. I wanted to capture this architecture in the reflections of the pool. And some people have asked me over the years, is it difficult to do that and get those reflections? And I said, no, because what I do is I just turn the canvas upside down and I paint the same image. Of course, you paint it a little more impressionistically, and that creates this very powerful reflection. And I think if you just look at the painting for a minute, it's just beautiful how it does. It even, the reflection itself is half the painting when you look at it. It doesn't seem that way when you first look at the painting, but when you take time to sit back and look at it, that's the effect that you have, and that's the effect that I wanted to achieve with this painting. It's a 24 by 32 inch painting and currently in the collection of Dennis and Grassi McGillicuddy in Sarasota, Florida. Now on this screen, we have two images. The top one is a pastel and the bottom is oil. And the story behind this, after I completed blocking in with on the canvas the previous painting, I lay that aside, and later that afternoon I went back to our little spot and I was turning to the left. Now this building on the top, which is in the pastel, I basically used my sketchbook and a few of my chalks. Now the purpose of this was I was concentrating more this is a closer view of the building than the previous painting, and it's a different building, different architecture. And I wanted to lay down the colors. So with chalk, I primarily get, it's obvious that I work a lot faster, but I try and block in the actual composition, and in this case, primarily the building, as opposed to concentration on the reflections. So it's a little closer view, the older windows, the archway. I mean, again, this architecture goes way back, hundreds of years. And the colors are primarily the same throughout Tuscany, those oranges and reds and the orange tiles and the soft siennas. But the blue and the gray of the walls, those are Etruscan period walls. So I felt that I had completed the composition as I wanted to end up putting on a canvas. And as you can see with the painting below, which I actually did at my studio, it pretty much stays true to the sketch. Although there's probably a little bit more detail in the reflections on the bottom of the page, but the colors are pretty similar. The actual design and the composition of the painting and the architecture remain the same, although there's a lot more detail. And the detail comes, I also, as I mentioned before, will take photographs of places that I am painting. So that allows me to get a little more detail in. Although this sketch is pretty accurate, and I'd have to say the final product, they're both final products. One's a nice pastel drawing, and the other is an oil painting, which was worked on at the studio and obviously takes a little more time. But they're both finished product. They're both different. Some people actually prefer original sketches than the final product, but I happen to like them both. The end of the result is the painting is pretty close to the drawing. And in this particular case, that's what I wanted. I would like to add that the oil painting is 24 by 32 inches and is in the collection of Bob and Catherine Carr of Sarasota, Florida. The pastel drawing is in my private collection, which is what I often do. I like keeping my original sketches. Okay, now we have two smaller paintings of the same subject, but totally different interpretations. Now, if you remember, the first painting that I discussed in this series was the painting I did from one side of the pool, looking over to the other side and the buildings and the architecture. And this little house was in the left of the main building. And when we got back to my studio in Florence, I decided I wanted to elaborate on this little house. And so the first painting I did was the one on the top. It's a brushwork. And I would say it's almost monochromatic, but it is there's a purity to this painting. There's a simplicity and a purity of those Tuscan earth tone colors, which I just really love. And I blocked it with the color of the trees, the little yellow and the greens, and that soft blue in the background. But again, it's almost like these perfect reflections at the bottom of the painting. You can get the image of the pool with just a couple of the little white lines. But again, so simple and really so pure, and it's so calming. So I decided to go a little crazier, and this other painting was pretty much done just with an all palette knife, and it was very quick. The top painting was a bit longer because I was in a little more detail and softer brush strokes, and there's a lot of paint on it. I kept working those colors to get that very smooth and pure quality. The bottom painting, however, is kind of a wild, and I mean, you just look at it and see this highlight, which is just two or three knife strokes with that white on the orange brown roof, and then the golden yellows. This was a lot of fun to paint. When you do a knife, you really can't make mistakes, because if you want to be bold, you can tell on the wall, you can see the palette itself in the thickness of the paint. So again, it's a quicker way to paint, but you don't want to make mistakes. And I think in the reflections in this bottom painting are just superb. You've got the purples in the trees, and again, there's the soft little line of the white to delineate the water. But same scene, totally different interpretations. I like them both, and I guess it would be up to the viewer to decide which one they like better. But again, so different, but capturing the essence of that beautiful little home. Now, this is the final painting that I'd like to talk about from the Bagno Vignoni series. This is a painting of my wife, Susan. who was sitting on the wall. One, I think this was the last afternoon that we were there. We were there a couple of days, and I was painting pretty much the whole time. And my easel, not an easel, but my sketchbook and my canvas were on this wall, and I'm looking at Susan, and I took a break, and I just took a couple of these quick photos, and I did the painting back at the studio in Florence. But not only is this just a serene and beautiful painting of Susan, the background itself is very typically Tuscan. I really think when you see the columns and the colors, the gold and the browns and the yellows balanced against the light grays of the background and the light blues and grays of the wall, the Etruscan stone wall, and then the reflections still to the right of her face. But again, she would be sitting there in the afternoon watching me work, and she was very, very relaxed and calm. This was so different from being in Florence with the hustle and the bustle and the noise with the motor, which we love, but it really is nice to get away. And I think this is a perfect example of how you can get relaxed in such a beautiful little village such as Bagno Vignoni. And I'd like to wrap it up with this quote. This quote is from Gerrit Henry, who was a critic in New York, who wrote for Art News and several other publications. He wrote this as an introduction to a book that we had for a show that I did at the Walter Wickizer Gallery. In fact, before we take a look at what he said, when I showed photos of my work to Walter before the show, he wanted us to put this painting in, but Susan and I decided against that because it's a very personal painting and we have it at our home. But again, I think Gerrit sums it up very nicely in a couple of these sentences, and we'll just go over it. He says, in a series of views of Bagno Vignoni, a small village with a spa where people have coming for healing effects for thousands of years, Kelley exhibits fascination with local phenomena and the near magical local ambience. Almost everything about his villagescapes shows a willing sensibility, happening upon, then truly recreating riflessioni, or reflections of a world that is now his own discovery. Thank you, Gerrit.